Thank you.
How do you feel winning in front of your hometown fans?
I feel good. I'm a little disappointed. In the second round, my left hand started bugging me, and it's swollen right now. And I got the victory. I'm happy, but I know I could have done better.
You said that you let the opponent like to crawl it out, and that's what you guys did. You guys went toe to toe. How do you feel about your performance tonight doing that?
It was good. I mean, I think it was entertaining. I could have boxed him the whole fight, but I thought it was getting boring, so I started brawling with him a little bit, and it was a good fight. I think the fans liked it. I heard a little bit of boos because I was boxing him, but that's why I started brawling.
You hit him with every shot you had. He didn't seem to have an effective answer. Do you feel like at this point in your career, you need to start being able to get guys like this out of here?
Yeah, I think I could have got this guy out if I would have kept working my left. But, it's hurting me right now. And everything just played out the way it did.
What round did you hurt your left hand?
In the second.
Is it swollen? Can we see it?
Yeah, it's swollen.
He was able to catch you a couple of times inside. He was laying on the rough. Did he hurt you at all? Did he have a heavy shot?
I was never like damaged or hurt or anything like that. He was a good fighter. He tried to catch me with that uppercut, and he just kept lunging in. And I could have boxed him the whole way, but I wanted to get him out too, so I started like trying to brawl with him.
And lastly, Julian, you know, at 15 wins, that's about that crossover time. You started to be facing better competitions, taking that step up. What do you need to do to get there, and who do you need to fight?
Whoever my promoter manager wanted me to fight, I think the better opponent, the more skilled opponent, the better I look. So whoever, you know, I'm just kind of step up and whoever wants to fight.
Yeah, she's Julian. 10 rounds of boxing, you gained some serious knowledge. How are you going to use that experience?
Every fighter is different. The next fighter I fight, he might be a boxer, you know. So I learned how to fight with this guy, a brawler, and he was trying to catch me with uppercuts and lunging in. And it was just a good fight, you know, learning experience. And I'm going to just go home, rest. Go back to the gym and just start practicing.
Following the footsteps of Chicanito Hernandez, did he ever give you any advice? Did he ever sit you down and give you a few pointers?
Just told me just to train hard so I couldn't feel my arms, and that was it. We didn't really talk about boxing that much.
And what happened when your opponent fell onto the canvas? You helped him up.
Oh, it's because we're lefty-righty, and that happens all the time. A lefty-righty, he tried to go to his right, and I tried to go to my left, and he tripped over, so, I just picked him up real quick. You know, I mean, it happens, lefty-righty, so.
You know, there were some rounds that fell, you know, that fell a bit flat, but then there were some heavy exchanges.
I could have boxed him the whole fight, and I just started to brawl with him, and that's what I did. I just started to brawl with him.
Julian, what's your official prediction from Matthysse Postol?
I think if Postol can't handle his punches, Matthysse gonna knock him out. But I saw Postol sparring at the wild card, and he looked like a good boxer. That's the first time I ever seen him. And hopefully Matthysse doesn't struggle against him because he's tall, because he struggled against Molina in the first round. So I think it's going to be a good fight. And in this fight right now, the Soto-Orozco fight, that's going to be a good fight.
It's happening now.
Yeah.
I want to go back and get ready.
Yeah.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you. Last question.
Thank you, dude.